The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 3, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on September 26, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Kitragan Shapimam Vidhi Sarva Khetreshu Bharata Khetra Khetra Gayak Jnanam Jatta Jnanam Matang Mama. Both of them are not in order. While discussing the subject matter of this body and the owner of the body, the soul and the super soul, we shall find there different topics of study, the Lord, the living entity, and matter. In every field of activities, in every body, there are two souls. The super soul and the individual soul. Sometimes the Mayavadi philosophers, they take it for acceptance that there is one soul only, super soul. But here we get from Krishna the authoritative source of knowledge. There are two souls, the individual soul and the super soul. Not one soul. Atma and Paramatma. Because the super soul is the plenary expansion of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, Krishna says, I am also the knower, but I am not the individual owner of the body. Last night we have already explained that the super soul or Krishna is the knower of the pains and pleasure of everybody, whereas the individual soul is the knower of pains and pleasure of his own body. In another place, Krishna says, Avinashi tu tad vidhi jena sarvam idam tatam. The consciousness of the individual soul is spread all over the body. That is Avinashi, indestructible. That is Avinashi. Krishna says, Avinashi tu tad vidhi jena sarvam idam tatam. Jena, by the soul, he is, by his potency, spread all over the body. Similarly, Krishna, being the super soul, he is not only spread, his consciousness is not only spread over this my individual body, but his consciousness is spread of all bodies. All over the universe, there are 8,400,000 species of forms, and Krishna's consciousness is all-pervading. He knows everything. So, as soon as our consciousness becomes Krishna conscious, Krishna understands. Krishna is within your heart. Ishvara sarva bhutana vidvesa arjuna krishnati. So Krishna can understand your purpose. We cannot cheat Krishna. Krishna can immediately understand how much serious and sincere you are for understanding Krishna or approaching Him or going back to Him, back to God. That Krishna can't understand. As soon as he understands that here is a soul, he is very serious, he takes care of, especially. Samoham sarvabhuteshu, Krishna being the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is equal to everyone. Samoham sarvabhuteshu, name deshasti na priya. Nobody is dearer or desha or subject, object of jealousy. Krishna is not envious, neither especially inclined to everyone. Actually, God's position is neutrality. Everyone He likes, for everyone. Suhidam sarvabhutana gyatamam shantimichyati. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. He is friend of everyone. We are seeking friendship with so many people to get our motive realized. But if we make Krishna, if we know Krishna is already ready, in the Upanishad it is said the two birds in friendly way is sitting on the same tree, the body. So, if we understand Krishna is my best friend, Krishna says, Sridhang Sarvabhutana, he is not only my friend, your friend, but he is a friend of everyone. So, that friendship is equally distributed. But if one becomes special, devotee, jetu bhajanti mang pritya, with love and affection, one who is engaged in the service of the Lord, he is especially inclined to him. That is Krishna's mercy to the devotee. Krishna is equal to everyone, but he is specially inclined to the devotees who is engaged in his service with love and faith. Tesham satatujuktanang bhajatang priti purvagam dadami buddhi yogam tam jinamam upijanti. Krishna gives it because he specially takes care of the devotee. So everyone's heart he is sitting. Khetragan chapi mang vidhi sarva khetri subharata. But he takes special care of the devotee, guides him, gives him intelligence. What kind of intelligence? Jena mam upajanti te. Just to give him the clue how one can go back to home, back to God. Krishna does not give intelligence how one can gain some material prosperity. That is entrusted to the Maya, the Devi Maya, or Durgadi. Therefore, people are not very much interested in worshipping Krishna. They are generally interested in worshipping Goddess Durga, Lord Shiva, because by worshipping Lord Shiva, Goddess Durga, they get material opulence. So, to worship the demigods means 100% materialism. There is no question of spiritual life. Therefore, Krishna says, what is that verse? Nasta buddha, kamastasta hitabhyana, jajante annadevata. Those who are interested in worshipping other demigods, their intelligence is taken away. Hitabhyana, kamastasta maya aparhitabhyana. These terms are there. Maya is working in two ways. Prakhyavatmika shakti, avarinatmika shakti. Avaranitka shakti means she is covering. avarani atmika shakti. She is covering. Real fact is covered by maya. Just like the cloud covers the sunshine. We cannot see. Now a few days is going on. There is cloud always. We do not see the sun. That does not mean there is no sun in the sky. So maya does not allow us to see Krishna. That is one shakti. Avarani atmika shakti. And another shakti is prakhepa atmika shakti. Even one desires to see Krishna, she throws away. She tests whether actually he wants Krishna or keeping Krishna in the front, he wants some material pleasure. Therefore, she throws away. In this way, maya shakti is acting. Krishna therefore says, Daivi jisa gunamai mamo maya duratya. Maya is very powerful. But if one is very rigid in devotional service, mami vaja prapadnanti, maya mitang taranti, he can overcome the influence of maya. So, khetragyam chapi mani vidhi, so that khetragyam, knower of the body, Krishna, he is also there. He is always ready to help us, provided we are serious about Krishna. That is Krishna's mercy. So this is the process of pleasing Krishna. Just like you are sitting here together and we are talking about Krishna. Our Krishna consciousness movement is specially meant for talking about Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ordered, Amar Agnay Guru Haiya Taro Ei Desh Jare Dakho Tare Kaho Krishna Upadesh. This is our mission. The Krishna Consciousness Movement means we are preaching the teachings of Krishna, Bhagavad Gita as it is, Krishna Upadesh. Another Krishna Upadesh about Krishna. Bhagavad Gita is the instruction given by Krishna, and Srimad Bhagavatam is the instruction given by Vyasadeva and other sages about Krishna. So both of them are Krishna Katha. So that is our mission, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. Jare dakho tare kaho Krishna upadesh. What Krishna is instructing directly, that is also Krishna upadesh. And what is being spoken about Krishna, that is also Krishna upadesh. So, the Bhagavad process is, if we want to improve, if we want to make our life successful, then we must engage ourselves in this program of Krishna consciousness or hearing about Krishna. Sinnathaṁ sakathā Krishna. Krishna is there. Kṛtavgaṁ chakvi māna vidhi. He is there, Krishna within your heart. So as soon as you are very serious and eager to know about Krishna, this is very nice science. If you simply know about Krishna, you become liberated. Janma karma me dibbam jo janati tatva. Simply try to understand Krishna. Tasmin vijñāte sarvamedam vijñātam bhavanti. This is the Vedic instinct. If you simply understand Krishna, then all other things becomes automatically known. You don't have to make separate endeavor to know. You'll know what is Paramatma, what is Brahma, what is this material world, what is this material nature, what is our relationship, everything will be revealed. Tesham aham ajnanajam tamo na śrāmi ātma bhāvasa. Krishna says to special favor, tesham evanukampartham aham ajnanajam tamah nasrayami atmabhavastra jnana deepena bhasata. This is Krishna's words in the Bhagavad Gita. If you actually become Krishna conscious, the result will be you will get special favor from Krishna. Tesham eva anukampartham. Krishna is specially favorable to the devotees. Jetu bhajanti maang pritya. Therefore, this is the beginning. This is the beginning of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also accepted this. Sthane sthita sutigatan tanubhanamano vi jnane prayasam udapasanamantaye. We have to be submissive, not a speculator that now I have become Brahma. Brahma, everyone is Brahma. There is no question of becoming Brahma. We are now forgotten. We have forgotten that we are Brahma. We are misidentifying with this body. This is Maya. Otherwise, therefore Bhagavad Gita says, Brahma Bhuta Prasanna. That is, it is not that by some process I become Brahma. I am Brahma. But on account of Maya, my knowledge is covered. I am thinking I am product of this material world. I am American, I am Indian. In terms of the soil where you have taken birth, jashatma buddhi punape tudhatuke sadhik kalatra disi bhomayidjadi. Bhomayidjadi. The whole world is mad after this process of bhomayidjadi. They are, instead of worshipping Krishna, they are worshipping the land in which one is born. That is called, under the name of going out, so many isms. So this is described as bhoma ijyadhi. But actually, we are part and parcel of Krishna. Krishna is Parabrahma. Therefore, we being part and parcel, we are also Brahma. Just like particles of gold is also gold. So there is no question of becoming Brahma. Brahma we are already. Simply, we have to know that I am not this body, aham brahmasmi. I am spirit soul, part and parcel of Krishna. That is knowledge. Jnanam gyam. Gyam, this knowledge, that I am Brahma. And as soon as we are perfectly situated in that spiritual knowledge, aham brahmasmi, then brahma bhuta prasannatma, na sochati na kanti. There is no lamentation. Everyone is lamenting because he is a Shudra. Shudra's business is to lament. But when one understands Brahman, Brahma Janati iti Brahman, he does not lament. We have seen many Brahmanas, they are not very materially opulent, but they are happy. They are happy with Krishna. That is Brahman's business. Brahmana Vaishnava. Brahmana must be a Vaishnava, Krishna conscious. If a Brahmana is not Vaishnava, then he cannot become Guru. That is the injunction of the Shastra. Satkarma nipuna vipra, mantra tantra visharat. A vipra, a Brahman, a learned. Vipra means a learned Brahman. Vidu pathat bhavet vipra, one who has learned, studied all the Vedic literatures and has acquired knowledge, he is called Vipra. So simply studying Vedic literature will not do. Brahma janati iti Brahma. He must realize what is Brahma. Then he becomes Brahma. Brahmana is a qualification. It is not by birth. Brahmana, just like High Court judge, is a qualification. It is not by birth. The High Court judge's son is not a High Court judge, unless he has the qualification of a High Court judge. Similarly, a son of a Brahman by birth is not a Brahman. When he has got the Brahminical qualification, then he becomes Brahman. That qualification are stated in the Bhagavad Gita. It is not imagination. Samadhamatiti khajava jnanam vijnanam asiktam brahma karma sabhav. So, these things are lost. Therefore, India's position is now chaos and confusion. Because you have lost this Vedic civilization, you have lost Krishna consciousness, you have lost God consciousness, you are being directed by the whims. So, it is very lamentable condition of India. Although this Krishna consciousness is from India's original culture, Krishna culture, Krishna appeared on this land, although Krishna is not for any particular land, but still Krishna appeared in this holy land of Bharatvarsha, Mathura. So it is the duty of the Indians to understand Krishna culture, Krishna consciousness cultural movement, and take part in it seriously. That is the instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He says, Bharat bhumite manusya janma hoila ja, janma sarthak kari karo paropaka. This is the injunction of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That anyone who has taken birth in the holy land of Bharatvarsha, Bharat bhumite manusya, of course if he is a man, if he is a cat and dog, that is a different thing. But Bharat bhumite manusya janma hoila ja, manusya. If he is a human being, then he must take advantage of the Vedic knowledge. Janma sarthak kari. Otherwise, what he is doing? If he does not know what is what, then what is the meaning of his preaching? No. So, janma sarthak kari karo paropaka. It is the duty of every Indian, every man who has taken birth in Bharatvarsha, to perform paropakar, to do well others. Because in the other part of the world, there is no such advantage of Vedic literature and Vedic knowledge. Unfortunately, the Indians are neglecting this Vedic perfection. Whereas in other parts of the world, the Europeans and Americans, they are taking interest. We are not, of course, concerned with any particular nation or country. Our business is to carry out the order of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Jare dakho tare kaho Krishna. Whomever you meet, it doesn't matter whether it's Indian, European, American or African. Anyone, he should be instructed about Krishna upadesh so that his life may be successful and the preacher of Krishna consciousness, his life also will become successful. This is Krishna consciousness movement. So, to become educated in the Krishna consciousness movement, this is the beginning. To hear about Krishna, to understand about Krishna. Sinnatham sapatha Krishna punna sravana kirtana riddanta savadrani vidunati suhisatam. Sinnatham sapatha Krishna. If you kindly hear about Krishna seriously, this is our program. We give chance everyone to hear about Krishna. We are trying to construct a temple here, not for making any profit, but to give chance to the people about hearing about Krishna. This is our mission. We are opening temples all over the world just to give people the chance to hear about Krishna. Because as soon as we seriously hear about Krishna, Sinnatham Sakata Krishna, Punna Sramana Kirtana, the Krishna is there. Khetragam Chapi Manaviti, Sarva Khetri is there everywhere. So as soon as that individual soul is seriously engaged in hearing about Krishna, immediately the dirty things within his heart becomes clean. Chita Dattpana Majanam Bhava Mahadavagni Dibbapana. And as soon as the heart is cleansed, his, all problems of this material world is solved. Bhava Mahadavas in his Papa. Because he understands. Cleansing the heart means to understand that he is not Krishna. He is part and parcel of Krishna. His duty is to serve Krishna. This is cleansing of heart. So long it is not cleansed, just like this Mayavadi philosopher, they are thinking themselves that they are Krishna. I am God. No, that is unclean. Vimukta manina, tayyasta bhavat abhishuddha buddha. Because their intelligence is not yet clear, it is still with dirty thing, therefore they are thinking that they are Krishna. No, Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and we are eternal servant of Krishna. This is the philosophy. Therefore Krishna demands in the Bhagavad Gita, sarva dharmān parityajya māme ekaṁ saraṇaṁ vraja. Just surrender to me. It is the right of the master to ask the servant that you surrender. Similarly, Krishna comes to teach this. Sarva dharmān parityajya māme ekaṁ saraṇaṁ, because we are eternally servant of Krishna. The Mayavadi philosopher, they cannot understand. The servant wants to become the master. That is not possible. That is not possible. If the servant remains a faithful servant, that is perfection of his life. Artificially, if the servant wants to become master, that is only botheration. So, the Krishna consciousness movement is educating everyone to understand this fact, that everyone is eternal servant of Krishna. Don't try to imitate Krishna. That is bhagavad. You cannot be happy. Artificially, if one wants to become something else which he is not, then it is simply moderation. There is no happiness. In artificial life is not happiness. Natural life is happiness. So, naturally, we are servant of Krishna. If you don't serve Krishna, then we have to serve Maya. Actually, people are engaged. Those who are not Krishna conscious, they have given up the servitude of Krishna, but they have accepted the servitude of so many other things. Somebody is thinking, I am the servant of my country. Somebody is thinking, I am servant of my family. Somebody is thinking, I am servant of my wife. Or somebody is thinking, I am servant of my office boss. Or somebody is thinking, I am servant of my dog. That is also going on. Servant he must remain. But if he does not become servant of Krishna, he has to become servant of somebody. He cannot give up his position as a servant. That is not possible. He may change the name in different way, but he remains a servant. That's a fact. So, therefore, one who is intelligent, one who is actually intelligent, he thinks that if my position is to become a servant, why not become the servant of the Supreme? This is intelligence. Kamadinam kutidhana kutidha palita dunnidesha tisang maina kuruna jata natrpa na pushanti. We are servant of our senses. Kamadinam kutidhana kutidha palita dunnidesha. And our senses are dictating so many nonsense things, and we are serving. So, therefore, one is not servant of the senses, but one he becomes servant of Krishna, then he becomes master of the senses. That is called Swami or Gurshan. One side you have to become servant of Krishna, then you become master of the senses. If you do not become servant of Krishna, then you become servant of the senses. Kama, dinam, kapidhan. The whole world is going on. Everyone is servant of the senses. Godas. So one has to become Goswami. Go means senses. So Krishna is advising that I am in everyone's heart. You can take advice from Krishna. Krishna is ready. Krishna's another name is Chaitya Guru. Chaitya Guru means the Guru who is situated within your heart. Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna.